Our lab is the LeBlanc Lab. We work on energy conversion technologies, and we specifically focus on developing advanced materials and manufacturing processes for devices that convert one form of energy to another. The graduate students are the ones who come up with a lot of the ideas in our lab. They come up with the ideas of what the experiments should be, how they should be executed. They learn all of the techniques that we use in the lab. How are we going to make things? How are we going to measure things?
The end goal of my research is to actually be able to 3D print thermoelectric materials, and these are applied in a number of different energy systems as well as practical systems.
So the goal here is to develop the capability to print electronic devices that won't have as fine a detail but can be made really cheaply and can be made very quickly, so that you can design some kind of electronic device and have it printed within the same day.
It's exciting to collaborate with academic researchers as well as industry specialists, and Dr. LeBlanc's lab is uniquely equipped to study selective laser melting, and it's exciting to have research work that there's a vested interest in actually applying our results in the near term.
A lot of times I think when people think of mechanical engineering, they think mostly that it's just dealing with machinery and there's not really a component that touches on like a human aspect. But tissue engineering, really the ultimate goal is that you're trying to improve a patient's life. I use 3D printing to print tissue engineering scaffolds, and I focus on the osteochondral region. So part of the scaffold, the lower part of the scaffold, targets bone tissue, and the upper part of the scaffold targets the cartilage tissue. And I'm trying to come up with a blend that has a nice transition from bone into cartilage for the surface of articulating joints.
My research generally focused on tissue engineering, and particularly nerve tissue engineering, creating a synthetic nerve scaffold. When I come to the lab, I spend most of time working with 3D printer to create this 3D scaffold model, and also spend a lot of time doing the cell culture experiments. What I enjoy most about working in Dr. Zhang's lab is the independent research that I can conduct here, because Dr. Zhang really appreciates self-motivations, and she really encourages us to do the independent research.
Prospective students looking to apply, I really suggest making a visit to campus and meeting with the professor you're interested in, and maybe a few other professors, and just kind of see what similar work is going on, and then try to set up a time where you can come to the lab. It's better if stuff is even going on and the students can kind of walk you through the work that they do, and you can really get a better idea of exactly start to finish how what you'll be doing on a day-to-day basis fits into the bigger picture and whether you'll be a good fit with that professor and with that lab.